to work through this, and now the perception is that they're being bullied. There was also this idea that once you make this demand public, now you run into the impression that you're bullying the franchise, which doesn't sit well with a lot of franchises. Usually trades like this, trade demands, do better when they're kept in-house and then they don't leak because you don't have the issue of pride coming into play here. And so I think if you had it to do over again, probably you could have asked for this in the summer or at the beginning. But this is New Orleans where, you know, I know Anthony wanted to give it a good go, right? He wanted to see how the season went. They had Meritage. That team did really well in the playoffs last year, and I think they had a reason to believe that they could replicate that and then maybe add a piece at the trade deadline. Maybe they could have got in to be in the conversation for Jimmy Butler and got the three men that they've needed for a long time, and none of those things happened.
Ramon, I hear you about keeping it in-house. Don't make a public announcement that you want to be traded. But how do you get some of your information about players?
Tracy!
I'm just saying, right? So why is a player, we got to stay silent? Because you get information from
the franchises.
From internally, from these organizations, and you put it out there about players being
on trade. This is our job, okay? And we live in a world now where it is almost impossible to keep things like this quiet for any length of time. I mean, I think that you can reasonably expect something like what happened with Porzingis and the Knicks, where they had a sense that this was heading in this direction. They had talked to...
But even that kind of leaked out. It's not like we didn't have months of people, but we had... And to the Knicks' point, this is to the Knicks' point, really. Yeah. The Knicks keep saying, hey, guys, we knew for months, and there was discussion for months that he wasn't really happy. We would have heard that about AD.
You know, one of the things I don't think we talked about quite enough is they talked to Porzingis about doing a contract extension in the offseason, and they were, and Porzingis and his agents were happy to wait. And the extension they would have done before the season would have been something like what Joel Embiid did with the Sixers, where it was like heavily
protected right,
and protecting the Knicks with his injuries. He'd have to play a certain amount of games. They were happy to wait.
Right.
And then the Knicks have all the information of how he behaves the rest of the year. He's not around the practice facility quite as much. That you have feelings about how a guy feels about your organization. And they had canvassed the league for a month or so of what the market would be. They had a pretty good sense of that before they made that deal. And so when that meeting happened, and I'm told it wasn't just scheduled on that day, it was scheduled and then rescheduled several times. It just happened to coincide
with
that morning when they already had the trade. That was their last chance to look him in the eye and say, do you want to be here or not? And he did not.
Well, speaking of the Knicks and a player they know so well, who also had an unceremonious exit, I want to talk about